Jackie. Here's a warm.
Hi. So this is a story of how I got banned from Caesars and one very sad boy's quest for love. So I worked in the Springfield Marpleton movie theater for many, many years. I met a lot of great people, a lot of friends, my husband there. And one of the friends that I made there, her name was Jill, and part of our job is to work with the IT department. Whenever our computers didn't work, we would call tech support, you know. And we met a very nice man on tech support. His name was Andrew, and he became our go-to tech guy for any of our questions or concerns. And I was 21 at the time, and Jill was a little older, and we would flirt with Andrew a little bit because we thought it was cool. We talked to him. He's from Georgia. We were from Pennsylvania. I never really ventured too far out of Delaware County, so it was pretty exotic to talk to somebody from Georgia. And some of the flirtation between Jill and Andrew got pretty intense, so much so that he decided he was going to come visit us. So, you know, Jill was excited. She thought it'd be awesome. Maybe this would be a guy she could date, you know, at least have a hookup. She was very young, in her 20s. So Andrew came all the way here from Georgia on his own dime. I can't imagine Radiant paid him that much money. So I remember very vividly taking Jill to the airport to meet Andrew. We were very excited. I'm like, this is going to be so amazing. This, you know, she's going to see this guy. She's going to hook up with him. It's going to be awesome. Get to the airport, and we see him get off the plane, and I'm like, oh, there's Andrew. And I turn and look at Jill, and her face was priceless. She hated him. And I could tell by looking at her that she did not want anything to do with him. And this poor guy was up here for just 2 days, and now I'm stuck with Andrew from Radiant and Jill, who hates him. And I had to figure out what to do because I felt really bad that he came all the way from Georgia to visit these two girls that were flirting on the phone with him. Now, I had a boyfriend, so I obviously didn't want anything to do with him, but Jill was supposed to be the one that he was here to visit. So I real quick tried to think of, well, what is something I could do with this guy from Georgia? And since I'm from Delaware County and I very rarely venture out, I thought, road trip to Atlantic City. Great, because Jill loves Atlantic City and sounds like a great idea. So from being at the theater, I made a lot of friends, and I said, hey, everybody, we're taking a road trip to Atlantic City. Who wants to come? And we ended up with two carloads full of people. So of those people was somebody that I was also friends with named John, and he was 40. I don't know why John was friends with all of us in our 20s at the theater, but he was. And I thought, great, let's bring John. He's an adult. He'll supervise. We're all barely 21, so if anything goes crazy, we can look to him. So we all piled in two cars, drove to Atlantic City, got there, went to Caesars. Not even an hour into the trip in Caesars, John was completely wasted and 40 years old. So, you know, everybody in the group got wasted. I'm not a big drinker, so I thought I'll be the designated driver. Very quickly, things turned very bad. We tried to bring John to the bathroom, and he got in a fight with one of the security guards. And 2 seconds later, I was getting screamed at by security. They're taking my ID down. Everyone's yelling, you're banned, you're banned, you're banned. And then here we are back in the garage, 2 hours. 2 hours. Andrew from Georgia came up here to visit this girl who hates him. We all went there. Jill drank her face off because she doesn't like Andrew and was stuck spending an entire weekend with a guy she didn't like. So here I am awkwardly trying to help out Andrew and make him feel welcome when the girl he likes wants nothing to do with him and this 40-year-old guy is completely wasted. So we get in the cars and I'm driving the one car and behind us is a car full of other people and friends and John is in that car. So on the way back, I take a wrong turn, and I'm headed down the wrong way trying to get home, and I get a phone call from the guy behind me, and he says, look, John, he's freaking out. He's not really breathing well. I think he's having a heart attack. Awesome. Here's Jill, doesn't want anything to do with Andrew. Here's Andrew from Georgia, and then behind us is John having a heart attack. So the trip quickly turned to a detour to the hospital. So now we're at the hospital with Andrew from Radiant, Jill, who wants something to do with him, and John, who's having a heart attack. Luckily, the story ends well, John, and I have a heart attack. However, on the way to the hospital, I was driving very, very fast in a car that wasn't mine, and I'm going to be honest, I'm not a great driver, and I missed the exit for the hospital, so I slammed the brakes on and actually pulled off onto the shoulder, and I turned around to tell Jill, you know, I missed the exit, and in my rear view comes my car full of friends behind me, who proceed to smash into the back of Jill's car, which is not my car, Jill's car. Jill's drunk in the back seat, not liking Andrew. Andrew's in the front seat, not being from here, being from Georgia. Now he's in a car accident. Now we're on the side of the road. I don't know if John's having a heart attack or not. So we end up driving the busted car to the hospital. John gets looked at. John doesn't have a heart attack, thank God. I end up driving everybody home. And at the end of the night, we go back to the hotel with Andrew from Radiant and Jill, who doesn't like him. So the next morning, everybody goes home. The next morning, we wake up, and we have to take Andrew back to the airport because, you know, he came up for one day in the hopes that he could hook up with Jill, and Jill wanted nothing to do with him. So I go back to the hotel, and I talk to Jill, and I said, listen, Jill, this guy came all the way from Georgia. We took him to Atlantic City for 2 hours, at which point we proceeded to get kicked out of the casino, drove home, got into a car accident, went to a hospital for 3 hours, and then took him back to a hotel by himself at the end of the night. I said, we cannot drive this guy back to the airport with nothing. I said, you have to go into that hotel room and do something with this guy. He did not come up here from Georgia for nothing. You have to do something. And she said, no, I can't. I don't really like him. I said, Joe, I know you don't like him. We have to take one for the team. I'm not asking you to go all the way. You can at least give him a hand job, something. We need something. He came all the way from Georgia. So I'm saying, sorry to say that this story sadly ends with us taking Andrew back to the airport where he flew back to Georgia without even a handoff. Jill's, you know, married now happily and about to have her first baby, and I am not legally allowed in the Caesars in Atlantic City anymore, all because I tried to help a lonely guy from Georgia named Andrew find love in Pennsylvania. Thank you.
Thank you, everybody.